Oh my goodness, after whooping OKC's butt, 142 to 90, a 52-point deficit. Oh, okay, I gotta see also Thunder's roster. Because remember, we played that with, a broken right toe for Chris Paul. And a severe right ankle sprain for Steven Adams, 2 to 4 weeks. That's why we basically won this game. By a blowout, because two of their big players for the Thunder are injured.
Welcome fans to 2K Sports Tuesday night presentation of NBA basketball. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Brett Barry and Greg Anthony. We've got David Aldridge reporting from the sideline. TA, take it away.
In the last few years, we've seen league-wide scoring surge in the NBA. Now, many credit years of defensive rules changes, such as limiting hand-checking on and off the ball and getting rid of contact in the paint. Now, everyone isn't pleased with these changes. Some say defense is no longer allowed. But a higher pace of play, more efficient shot selection, and lots of threes also play a role. Most fans aren't complaining. Devin?
It sure is fun to watch, DA. Thank you. And a chance to take a look at some numbers for him.
And it's a nice month he's having. Something's got him motivated. He's become a much bigger contributor.
Oh my god, I was like 50%. Now I'm 59%. Or I was 52 for the season now.
So the opening lineup for the Suns. Šarić and Ayton at the 4 and the 5. Then it's Will Barton. Then there's Devin Booker. And it's Jerome in at the 1. And for Dallas, Doncic and Porzingis, the incredible forward pair. Then there's Hardaway, and it's Kleba in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Brent, as the season goes on, here we are about halfway through. Are players' roles still evolving?
Not the starters at this point, Kevin. They're pretty much.
That does not look anything like Kelly Oubre. You guys notice that? That does not look anything like him in real life. In real life, he's much more prettier. 2K, he looks ugly.
Which of my lineups that I can have out there that defensively I'm going to shut down great guard play? Which of the lineups do I have to have out there in order for us to have an enhanced shooting ability for a stretch of minutes? Which ones are going to speed my team up to put pressure on the opposition? I think that's where it is that coaches are trying to do a little bit of tweaking.
A wide open look here for Porzingis. Offline with his three. To the inside. The shot by Šarić. No good. For the Phoenix Suns, they're coming off a good outing against the Grizzlies.
Oh, they have Kleber starting.
Two teammates connecting right.
Whatever you say that guy's name. His last name.
Martin passes to Book. Now here's Šarić. Here's Jerome.
Jerome? My cousin Jerome? I have two of them.
Phoenix, no good that time either. And here we go, the Mavericks in a fast break.
And running with a full head of steam, but completely under control. Do you think he's comfortable at that speed? He's done it so many times before. Just an absolute blur in transition, and that helps get the rhythm going.
Ayton tries Book. It's blocked. A solo fast break. A finish. Rips down the breakaway slam.
Inflicting some punishment with the two-hand club.
They're going for the throat. Now, here's Barton. 11 points for him in that last game against the Grizzlies in Memphis. Pass to Booker. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Over Hardaway. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Ayton.
That is just a careless turnover. You've got to be smarter in those exchanges.
We're just about 2 minutes into the first quarter. Guys, we've seen some excellent offensive output.
Yeah, great momentum for them offensively.
For Phoenix, they've gone 0-5.
Oh, how did I steal that?
Start for them. Here's Jerome. Good for the basket. Starting off 1-5 with that shot.
working his way for a high percentage look. That's just smart basketball.
And that's a painted possession right there.
There we go.
Piece, especially when the defense is not a factor.
Just a great hustle play there. Energy and passion. This is what you play the game for.
Saric outside. Passes it to Barton. Some nice ball movement here by the Suns. Ayton kicks to Barton. It's blocked. Fires from the wing.
I did not even mean to shoot that.
Out of bounds, Phoenix takes possession.
And quickly, I was going to dunk it, but it didn't give me that off animation, but okay.
Four rebounds and three assists. And he's done his share of the work for the team, definitely making an impact.
Well, the numbers, if you look at them, impressive all the way around, and he's not letting the team down.
Here's Booker. There we go. Now in the scoring column with that make, he is 1 for 4.
And Booker, no fear at going to the basket. He's got the size as a two guard to do that.
There's the triple. Another three for Dallas.
Defense shaking their heads. No idea how to stop him in this quarter. He's got him on the ropes.
Suns trail by 8.
I got them on the floor. How about that?
And we're approaching about 3.5 minutes played in the first quarter.
Block.
Ayton finds Barton. And it's off from 3-point range. At the elbow, Doncic.
Nice pass, Luka.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Jerome passes to Saric. Doncic against Barton. Takes the three. Here's Ayton. Uses the glass.
DeAndre Ayton.
Yeah, if Ayton can get in that kind of position, he could be a bully on the inside.
From deep three-point range, the long distance squeeze there. 15 points in the game.
I already got 15 points. I've literally almost outscored the Thunder. Literally almost in three quarters before they subbed me.
DeAndre is going to be all about the pick and roll, both how he runs it and defensively.
I agree, Kevin. If he works with Devin Booker out there as an offensive threat and becomes a guy who can roll
that's 3 seconds?
His hands and finish, that's a key for their offense.
Okay. It was a 3 seconds.
Size, defensively, he can be imposing. Can't talk enough about the subtleties in that setup right there. The assist, really the key to that entire sequence.
Chance with authority.
Displaying intensity right off the opening tip, especially on the offensive end.
Yeah, if you walked in at any point during this game to watch 5 minutes of play, one team played harder. We know who that was.
And it's the Suns with the ball, following the score by Dallas.
I'll give it to Devin.
Here's Jerome. He's averaging a bit over 5 points a game. Shoots the three. It's rebounded by Doncic. Doncic has got 4 rebounds in this game. To the middle for Zingas. Good. And the assist goes to Doncic.
And you can't help but pick their defense apart. They're completely in disarray.
Here's Jerome. And the foul called on Porzingis. That's his first foul. There are a few players now host podcasts, participate with those elements, with those vehicles during the season. Any thoughts on that?
I think it's great. I think it's fantastic for our fan
base. Uber's in.
For our players to have an outlet, to have conversations and share a little bit more about their personality. It grows them as people, I think, Kevin, especially I've listened to J.J. Redick many times over. Yeah. You learn something new, not only about players, but about their interests and how they're spending time. And I think if you were a young player, let's say you were a high school senior, you're a college player, and you're listening to some of the things that guys are talking about and their experiences, I think it's invaluable for what it is that you don't know.
Damn, DeAndre.
Around a player in the NBA.
DeAndre.
And for you to start having considerations about how difficult
DeAndre with the finish.
How mentally taxing. So this is a great outlet for
you. Nail from 3-point land.
Gold ankle breaker, green machine on silver. It's fire.
Kicks to Oubre.
Imagine me getting like a lot of like shooting badges.
Booker outside. Front past the arc. He can't get that one to fall. Great tee that time from Hardaway.
They've been beating them to a lot of those loose balls and rebounds here to start.
To the left wing. Here's Porzingis.
That's the first shot I've ever made with Porzingis.
And the Mavericks lead by 17.
Oh, this is the kind of start they were hoping for.
Šarić against Porzingis. Here's Booker. Šarić trying to break free. A nice shot by Booker.
And Devin Booker showing a nice touch around the rim.
Mavericks leading by 15. Doncic with it. He had 13 points in the win against Oklahoma City.
Yeah, but all around offensively, the performance was great. He knew when he had it going, but he also knew he could get other guys going. So his passing right up there on the level with his scoring in that one.
Now here's Booker. Good ball movement here by the Suns. Here's Jerome. The feed to Šarić. Porzingis with the block.
Good luck getting a shot over the 7 foot, 6 inch tall wing.
I just drew. I passed right by Devin Booker. Booker just turned around. It's like a football spin back. Like in a slow animation.
Hustle plays have meant so much to this team. Now just sustain some of that energy into contributions and just little things that guys were doing to chip in for that win.
And a new group getting ready for Dallas. Marjanovic checked in for Maxi Kleba. Life foul comes in for Porzingis. Maurice checked in for Doncic. And it's right in for Tim Hardaway Jr. Here's Baines. It's good. He makes his first shot of the game.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Down low. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
Robot's coming off the bench for us for this game.
Top shooters from deep this month. These guys have been raining down threes lately. Fifth on the list, Devin Booker.
Sometimes a three-point shooter gets into that rhythm and just keeps carrying it over. That's been the case for him the entire month.
Let's see if I can make a three as Boban.
So he gets them both. Suns trail by 19. Takes the 13-footer. Misses off the right eye.
With him struggling tonight, they need to find some other options out there to keep themselves in the game.
And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
Taking a look at some numbers.
Murray.
Just an incredible month of basketball. Sixth in blocks, eighth in rebounding. And he's in the top 10 in field goal percentage. Really able to.
I feel like Murray doesn't even get like that much scoring. He's only here for his defense. Because I see that defensive badge that he has.
That's why he's a top 10 shot blocker. He's off on the second. Replay angles are interesting. Brent, instant feedback on social media. Talk about.
Oh, he got the end one.
On referees to get every call right.
So many times, Kevin, on nights where you're working games, you sit there for a minute, and a half.
In super slow motion looking at the play.
And still sometimes hard to get it right.
Very hard.
What I think the league should think about doing with the competition committee is every team in the league should have 3 and 4 cameras that are mounted so that every time there's a replay at any given arena, they have access to the same angle.
For every game.
Every game. Where are most of the times these calls being missed? Where are these calls getting wrong? And how is it that we can implement some technology to help us not only get it right more often, which is the most important thing, but also fair and balanced vision for the referees to have an opportunity to do so?
What an excellent idea. Suns trail by 19. And here's Booker, one of the most consistent producers in the league. He's averaging around 25 and a half points a game. Pass to Kaminsky.
I
That's tipped. Shot clock at 4, and it's good on the way up.
You're going to use this takeover.
Leading by 17. And it's Marjanovic on top of the
no!
Key. Pass to right. Inside. And there's a slam dunk to finish it off.
Wow. We are going to remember that one for a while.
I know I wrote, Ray. That was special. That was really special. Now here's Booker. A rebound by Marjanovic.
Now, one player sometimes can drag down your offense. He seems to be an anchor here in this quarter.
Love seeing a point guard who can explode to the rim like that.
Oh, great attitude and even a better finish.
Well, just seeking out weaknesses in the defense and then exploiting it.
And that one,
Booker wants that and one.
Points they scored in the paint already here. It is eye-opening.
Oh, in and out.
Pulls it down. Suns trail by 19. Here's Bridges. Off with the layup.
I'm not sure where the lack of focus comes in there, Kevin. That's not like him. The defense is close, but there's enough space to score.
Rejected by Booker. 3 second difference between shot clock and game clock. Oubre can't get it to go.
I know it's about defending the post and the three-point line these days, but still got to be active in the mid-range area, and the defense gets away with one there.
Jacks up a three. Oh, to beat the clock. Oh, what a play!
Bro! Boban just took down Devin Booker with that screen, and I hit the deep three.
For the defense, too. You just give up momentum like that at the end of the quarter.
And that's it for the first quarter in what's been a fairly lopsided game. It's Dallas running away with it. Dallas going with a whole new group out there. Booker looking around. Passes to Baines. Now, here's Ayton, guarded by Porzingis. Bucket is good, and it's 6 points for DeAndre Ayton.
And their shots are falling now with more regularity than we saw at first.
Doncic and Porzingis, the incredible forward pair. Then there's Tim Hardaway Jr. And it's Kleba in at the five down low. That's the lineup in the game for Dallas. And Ayton throws it down.
Yeah, no big guys dunking.
Oh, that was a 13-5 run, though.
Kevin Ayton up there for the rim rocker.
It's up a three. And that's out of bounds. Dallas will retain possession. And the voting for the dunk contest is just about over. So let's bring up the leading contenders for you.
Oh, am I in it?
The players on this list, you know this year's contest is going to be a fun one.
It is. And with their places in the contest almost wrapped up, I'm sure these guys are working on their moves already.
Some might say he's a long shot at this point, but you never know.
Hey, stranger things.
That shit out of here, bitch.
Have to wait and see.
And the list of participants is going to be final soon, so we'll be sure to keep you posted. This year's dunk contest should be a very special one.
And every year, it seems, we see something in the dunk contest that we've never seen before. And I don't think this year will be any different.
On the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, guys, one of the things that the NBA has been forward-thinking about is always accepting new ideas. And they've got a bunch of them on the table in recent weeks. Mid-season tournament, a postseason play-in tournament, maybe even reducing the 82-game regular season schedule. All of these would be very bold moves, but Commissioner Adam Silver has always demonstrated a willingness to think outside the box. Kevin?
The great adjustment, good report, thank you so much. Here's Jerome, following the score by now.
Come on, Jerome.
Clock at 6, the pass to Šarić. Phoenix needs to get off the shot. Pass break, Dallas. Doncic leading the charge. Down it goes for his third basket in as many tries.
How many times? times have we seen a possession like that from them today, ending with a basket coming off a free pass?
Look at all the coaching changes that the Suns have had through the years, and some of these young players have heard a lot of voices. 7 in the last 8 years, and the team's performance has shown that kind of inconsistency with up and down seasons.
Cleveland.
Yikes. Yikes.
Suns trail by 20. Look loose. Here's Ayton. It's one.
Bro.
And it's the Mavericks on the break.
Oh.
No good. Enzo Booker will bring it up for Phoenix. And all the system changes have really affected the Suns scouting department.
Really difficult to fill out a roster when you've got coaching changes and philosophies that come about, and some guys simply just don't.
Yeah, fight. Good foul. Good foul.
Maybe they settle in here, find the right guys to do the right things, and get themselves back into
Aaron
the
Baines, the Curry hand herder. He didn't hurt me.
What improvements, Brent, do you like to see out of players going from season one to the second season in the league?
Biggest thing, Kevin, turnovers. Player comes into the league, has an opportunity to play, wants to rush things, plays too fast, doesn't have an ability to slow down and make leads. From season one to season two, and given the role and responsibility for that player, when you watch a guy whose ability to take away the mistakes, the simple mistakes he made last year, that's growth.
Because it's connected to so many other areas of his game.
Right, and he's not trying to do things that he wasn't capable of doing when he came into the league last year. He's understanding more of where it is that he's best suited in possessions and for that offense.
Good explanation. Here's Baines. Taking a look at his numbers, he averages about 7 points a game. Here's the break. Hardaway with a wide-open look. A three-pointer off the mark. Phoenix has gotten half their shots from three-point range to go down to the second quarter. 3 of 6 from downtown. Here's Booker. That one misses. Now the Mavericks take it the other way. They went to Phoenix for their last meeting with the Suns.
There we go.
Not a close contest.
That's what I wanted. The lob to Luka.
Rotation played solid in the bench. What's the difference?
Second unit came in last game and just played lights out basketball. I'm sure they'd like to do that again.
The Suns have made 2 of the previous 3 free throws in today's game. The first free throw is good. Kelly Oubre checked in for Phoenix. Good on both.
Yeah, in this quarter, they've had the right approach, driving and drawing, initiating contact, create opportunities, get to the line.
Out to Doncic. All the way up top. To the paint. Oubre pulls it in. The Suns shooting in the second quarter, right around 48%. Jerome looking to get back on track here. Porzingis with the rebound. Porzingis has got 4 rebounds now tonight.
Well, his shooting this quarter has to be a huge concern, especially when they're behind like this. Can he find a rhythm?
Same spot. Same spot. That's the same spot.
Basketball IQ is something that gets talked about, but its importance to a team showing up here, running plays that turn into scores.
A dominating first half of basketball, and so far hasn't been close. The Mavericks on top. They finish off the second quarter on a 14-5 run. And don't go away, we'll be back momentarily.
hit 7 threes in the first half.
And with a big gap on the scoreboard, the second half begins with very different goals for these teams. One side trying to mount a comeback, one side trying to protect their lead. Third quarter action getting rolling right now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's who's on the floor. On the court for the Suns, Sharic and Aiton at the 4 and the 5. Then it's Will Barton, then there's Devin Booker, and it's Jerome in at the point. Here's Jerome. Tim Hardaway making his last shot. Mavericks with the rebound. Doncic has got 12 rebounds here tonight. Big time effort. Fires the three. Another three for Dallas.
Having a lot of trouble stopping the three-point shot.
Here's Jerome. Porzingis with the block. Sharic passes to Jerome. 4 on the clock. Tries again.
They go bum.
A shot. A real slow start here in the second half.
Hardaway. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
He's a decent scorer and Hardaway.
What is this field goal?
So he draws defenders.
Was it like 2 of 15 or something?
And these are his second and third free throws tonight. And the first one at the line is good.
Three-point lead.
Tim Hardaway Jr. has some nights where it just looks effortless for him to get out and get 20 points. It's nice when he rebounds and passes in those games as well, showing complete game.
Now here's Barton. He's got 7. Pass to Jerome. They need this.
No, he doesn't.
Pull it in.
Time for some consideration in the passing category, maybe, Kevin. The shot is just not on. Get somebody else going.
Doncic dishes to Hardaway. To the middle. And he stuffs it. What a pass to set him up.
They have a good plan going right now, and they're starting to create separation.
Well, game plan might have been good, but you have to bring it together. Right now, their chemistry is something to be admired.
And it's the Suns with the ball. Following the score by Dallas. Passes it to Jerome. Kleba with the rebound. Kleba's got 6 rebounds now in the game.
Hate to say it, but if they're still trailing... this is good to be held by him. His shooting tonight...
I was hoping you fucking...
Barton passes to Jerome. Phoenix, no,
I was hoping if Aiden did not turn around, but he did. He like turned around the last second as soon as they're gonna shoot it. You bastard, DeAndre.
The amount of speed and agility he has for a player as solid as Aiden is doesn't come around very often.
Sharic passes to Jerome. Here's Aiden. Hands the shot.
Okay.
Aiton's got 12 in the game.
And with that one, he halts an 11-0 run by Dallas.
And those physical attributes of Aiton are so imposing. Greg, who does he remind you of?
I mean, for current players, you see a bit of Embiid and how they both move so fluidly for 7-footers. From the past, I see a bit of David Robinson in his game.
And that one drops.
Booker to the cup with confidence. Feels like he can beat anybody off the dribble right now.
It's fucking... Ian.
In the third quarter with just over 3.5 minutes off the clock.
Give me that shit.
The Mavericks have gone 4-7 to get things started here in the second half. To the inside. And the dunk by Porzingis.
Porzingis finishing strong that time. No doubt about that one.
At the elbow with Sharic. Down low, here's Jerome. And the
he made a fucking point.
With the dunk at the other end.
which can make it so much
but this is the last time you ever have a point.
You throw that lead pass that gets to him right on the money, whether that's on the run or in the shooting pocket.
Doncic outside. Out left to the wing. Pulls it up. Makes no mistake on the open jump shot. And he has 42.
And how about the vision there from Doncic? Can make the easy pass and also the difficult one.
Jerome passes to Barton. Now here's a
they're double teaming him. Jump ball.
And we're gonna have a jump ball. It's tied up there.
Damn! DeAndre, you just got suspended for 25 games. You don't need to be suspended like 20 more.
And here are the Suns now. Saric passes to Booker. Five on the clock. Shot from the wing. And that one hits back iron.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
All alone. And another basket for Dallas.
This is why I love his game. You really have to admire his tenacity.
Here's Jerome. Charge trying to break.
Defensive breakdown. I lose the takeover? What? Right there. I mean, for defensive breakdown? Get out of here. I hate that. Let's get it right back. That's how you call up a defensive breakdown. How about that?
They're in a very smart offensive performance tonight from him.
Booker outside.
How did I get a defensive breakdown when I was right there and I lose my takeover? That's stupid.
Fires for three. The Mavericks pull it in.
Another way to get out of a funk. Needs to be looking
Booker's
for
turn.
Good, solid, more efficient
okay.
shots. Not the wild one he took there.
Nope. On the wing. You thought.
Out to the right wing.
Oh, yikes.
He has the size. He can get up quickly. Aiden with the throwback.
I still made it in, but damn it. I got stuck in the animation.
Right. Dallas moving it around. Three-pointer.
Nice.
Good. Another from three. Buries his 10th triple of the game.
Unbelievable.
And so Booker will bring it up for Phoenix. The Oklahoma City Thunder will be in town for the next one. That game is the first and last of their homestand. Over to the wing. Baines dishes to Oubre. Powell pulls it in.
And physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. A plus 10 rebound advantage.
Fuck! Maybe I shouldn't have taken it.
In the corner, it's Bridges. He can't hit that time. And it's Dallas the other way. A minute 20 left in the third. On Spanish from right, Jovanovic.
Great use of the bounce pass. Thumbs down on that one, Kevin. Tough to defend against.
Phoenix has gone into a slump here from three-point range, shooting just 1 of 5 here in the third. Now, Booker, he's got 8. But Trey trains the three-pointer. Booker's got 5 points in the quarter.
Tough to guard Devin Booker on a quick pick and roll with his size and speed. He can be very dangerous in these sets.
Phoenix has gone a less than productive 2 of 6 from three-point land in the second half. Murray against Oubre. From the arc. The rebound by Marjanovic. Marjanovic has got rebound number 7 for him tonight. There's 25 seconds left to play here in the third. Murray against Oubre. Clock at 4. Pulls up. Offensive rebound.
And 1.
And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. Frank Kaminsky picks one up.
Wow, he got whacked on that one. Shouldn't be much debate there.
The Mavericks have shot 9 of 11 at the free throw line.
And they've had really good numbers all season from the free throw line.
And he sinks the second. 11 seconds left in the third quarter. Now here's Booker.
No, Booker. I said Booker. I mean, he is a Booker.
The scoring has been tremendous, and they are shooting lights out with very high accuracy. We'll get right back to the action when we return. And it's time now to bring you our State Farm assist of the game.
And you know, you can always count on him for at least a couple of these pretty
assists. Is it the lob and look up?
Course of a game, and
yes,
one,
it's the one.
A thing of beauty.
Sometimes when the offense is struggling, but every now and then this.
I was waiting for that.
Uptick right there. Great job of setting his teammate up.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. They've got Jackson. He's out there with Curry. J.J. Barea is out there with Marjanovic. That's the lineup out there for the Mavericks. Here's Oubre. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. And whether or not he's making shots, you have to love what Kelly Oubre brings on defense.
Yeah, the versatility on the defensive end. Maybe to a point, Kevin, where he can guard the 1 through 4.
See that right there? It does not look anything like him.
Staff excited.
You know, the NBA, not the only league with great players and great play. Talk about some of the other prominent leagues around the world. There's some terrific competition.
There's some great competition overseas in the Turkish leagues. Some very good players that play in the Russian league. There are some great players who are coming out of Australia, and we're actually seeing players now skip playing in the G League to go down to Australia to start their development and professional career. So, when we talk about the world game, Kevin, we're not joking around. It's a very real thing, and we continue to invite the best players that we can find, and they come from all over.
Is his name? Oh, I thought his last name said League. He's look where he's from. He said he's from none. He said his location from none.
On the second, so he makes them both.
Wow, he's from none.
From the charity strike.
He's from parts unknown.
And we played through about a minute here in the fourth. Hits it again. Wow,
and he's up to 52 points.
Yeah, making a GA look all too easy right now. There's the pass to Johnson. To Oubre. Six to shoot. What cue? They get it back. Baines. And that one is good with the extra effort on the glass.
Such a big part of what he does for this team. Just work and work on the boards, generate second chance opportunities, and hopefully convert.
Gets the 3-point of the ball.
It's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
Yeah, pretty infectious right here. Guys in good spirits and percentages from downtown on the rise in the second half.
Phoenix with the ball. Following the 3-point basket by Dallas. And it goes down 2 points.
Oh, that was a long two.
Mavericks have gotten all three of their shots to drop here in the fourth quarter. They came out of the break on a roll. We have seen some players refuse to speak to the media. For whatever reason, where should that line be drawn?
Well, there is a role and a responsibility, I think, of every player in the league, Kevin, given that it's an entertainment industry and that people have jobs around this league to tell stories, to have access to those players. Now, every player doesn't want to talk or get into certain things, but their availability should be made, and people should have access to them. Look, I don't want to take out the trash every Tuesday, but I understand I got to do it at home, and so players have a responsibility to their franchise to be a voice at times.
I always thought you were terrific with the media.
Well, I appreciate that, Kevin. Maybe that's how I got this job.
Maybe that's how I got this job. Is this Bill
Here's
Simmons?
After the Mavericks pick up three, after Okobo. Mavericks with the rebound. Marjanovic has got 9 rebounds in the game. Getting it done. Outside Curry. Passes it to Marjanovic. Some nice passing here by Dallas. Puts it up. They shoot again. To the wing right side. From deep, Berea.
Oh, Berea just getting looks, but still.
Numbers, but great effort in this one. Sounds funny, but I think he's been a positive for them. Mid-range is where he makes the money. So when he's slow to get out on him, always surprising to see him miss from there. That is all timing right
there.
Just
3 more rebounds to get my third triple-double.
And it's Okobo with the ball for the Phoenix Suns. Johnson outside. The pass to Oubre. And Baines kicks to Oubre.
Oh, good try.
And the Mavericks making a change.
Good try, Boban.
Checked in. And a change for the Suns. Martin's checked in for Kelly Oubre. 5 to shoot. And it's Baines in the corner. And again, it's the Suns missing. The Mavericks have gone 5 for 9 from the field in the final quarter so far. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.
This is Justin Jackson, right? He doesn't even get playing time.
Where it was in that first half.
First free throw is good.
Yeah, and their free throw shooting has really improved here in the second half.
Diallo, he's checked in for Aaron Baines. Jackson, it's both of them.
And this team will make you pay when they get chances at the free throw line. It's helped them pull ahead here today.
Here's Okobo. Martin finds Johnson. Trying to end the drought. No good on the shot. A bit long that time. Dallas has gotten off 4 three-pointers in the final quarter, and 2 of them have lost. Missing stats from the 60s and 70s, but if we could go back and look at those actual numbers, any players you think would really be catching our eye in terms of, wow, I didn't know that guy was that good, or he's better than I thought he was?
Well, don't we always look at the incredible, mind-boggling numbers of
Will Chamberlain,
and think, what was that guy doing?
Yeah.
And we don't even have half of it.
No.
So Will Chamberlain comes to mind first. What I think about, Kevin, when that question comes up is, how many great players through the 70s and also really through the 80s, because the three-point line wasn't accentuated enough, missed the opportunity to be even greater scorers? I mean, Jerry West with a three-point line, and
you
got to be kidding me. So there's a lot of gap of those players, too, that also because of changes in rules and because the three-point line wasn't in, that we would be talking about in terms of nostalgia and their accomplishments with a much different voice.
Even someone as recent as Jordan, with the rules the way they are now.
Absolutely.
Yeah, unbelievable.
With the openness of the floor and what Michael could do, as if he wanted to prove.
Damn it, I was going to run. If he missed it, I was going to get my 10th rebound.
And do a pretty good groove, going 6-10 here in the final quarter. Pass to Marjanovic. And the shot goes down. That gives him a double-double in this one. 11 points and 11 rebounds. Martin surveying the floor. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Martin's got 5 points now this quarter.
Man, he's just been impressive tonight and efficient from everywhere on the floor. Perfect night.
Inside, here's Bojanovic. No good on the shot, and Phoenix will come the other way. Lacue, guarded by Curry. Here's Okobo.
And the basket. Oh, that's some bullshit.
He's got a chance here for one more at the line.
That basket must be widening out right now, Kevin. He's making almost every shot he's putting up this quarter.
Murray's checked in for Tim Hardaway Jr. Bridges is checked in for the Suns. And
ow!
You know, Brent, how candid can players be in their answers in the post-game interviews about what is happening and what they're feeling at that time? In other words, is there a danger of being too honest as a player?
There could be, Kevin. I mean, anytime you express some of your vulnerabilities, and if it's done at the right time, somebody's going to take advantage of it. What we've seen over the past couple of years is, forget about when it is that the media is asking the questions. Most players are taking it to their social media accounts where they're able to get the message out without being baited by somebody with regards to a question. They can expound on whatever it is that they're feeling at that time. And that helps them to control the messaging a little bit more. And I think that trend is going to continue to grow.
And the Mavericks with possession here after the Suns pick up two. Murray kicks to Kirk. Pass to Bojanovic. Down through the hoop it goes. That's his fifth make on nine shots from the floor.
Textbook. Nice pass. Great catch. Even better finish.
Here's Okobo. Johnson. A second chance effort. It's good.
Damn it.
Johnson's got his first bucket in this one.
Controlling the defensive glass has been a problem here tonight.
From deep, three-point rip, and again for
hey guys, this is a historic shooting night for him. Tied for third now, most threes in a game.
The points, GA, just keep piling up, and the threes keep dropping in. He is red hot from beyond the arc. Knocks it loose. And the ball's tied up, so we'll have a jump ball. Brent, with advanced analytics becoming commonplace in the NBA, which stats do you personally hold most value?
Well, it's amazing to talk about effective field goal percentage. I laugh a lot
about free throws.
Yeah, well, you would use, I like to use...
Seth, why can't you do that all the time when I give you the ball? All you do is just brick.
But in talking to a lot of people around the league, general managers and coaches, I laughed inside to myself a little bit, like, well, so now shooting's important? Like, what? Like now shooting's important around the league? As if, you know, the time that you go out to start playing basketball, you grab a ball, you go towards the goal, and your goal is to make the shot. And so we're talking so much more about how much shooting is valued. Effective field goal percentage is tremendous, with true shooting percentage being not far behind.
Here's Jackson following the score by Phoenix. It's not going to go for him. To the paint, here's Okobo.
Maverick, there you go, triple double.
And what a fireworks display he's shown us tonight. Just keeps knocking him down from deep.
Greg, he has just exploded from beyond the arc. That last make tying him for second in most threes in a game. Diallo, the pass to Bridges. And he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim.
I'm about to tie my record.
55 left in the fourth quarter. Let's it go with a three. And again for three.
There it is. A shot that puts him at the top of the record book.
Well, Greg is now tied for the mark for most threes in a single game. In one word, amazing. Shoots.
Damn it. I was too salty.
Sorts of time. No good on that one.
Yeah, that miss might stick with him for a little while. That's kind of a shoot-around jumper if I've ever seen one.
And one team is just completely outclassing the other tonight. Spirited performance and it really ignited what is turning out to be a monster win here for Dallas.
It was a standout performance across the board.
I mean, it was like watching a cat play with a mouse, and they were able to do more or less whatever they wanted.
And this will push their record to 39 wins and a good effort tonight.
And once the horn sounds, they're going to go up 2-0 in the season series.
And here are the Suns now. The Mavericks making the shot. The rebound by Marjanovic.
And the effort never stops with him. No easy shots when he's on the floor.
Well, it's about the defensive end, and that's what guys...
Murray missed the wide open. He's like our flight. Black team, stand up!
Feeds it to Johnson. And the slam dunk by Johnson.
Oh, we're going to break it right here.
Agility coming from the big man. I mean, that's not something we often see from him.
You know, it's never going to be, Greg, a 360 dunk when he goes up with it, but it will be 2 points. We do know.
Oh, I'm not going to get it, though.
Well, he's obviously got the length there to make those kind of plays. Just needs to attack more, and that time he did.
Bridges against Murray. But Hugh misses the three. Out of bounds.
No, I'm not gonna get it. You shit. That was close.
So no problem for Dallas as they get the win. They quartered on tonight. Dominant showing in front of a crowd that loved every minute of it.
And you know, this game could really be a defining one for what they can do when they are playing at their best. I mean, being here at home, no doubt helps.
Third triple double of the season in my career.
Flawless. And now let's catch up with David.
Was, I have more
from the sideline. Right,
triple doubles in 2K20 than I did last year. Last year I only had one.
Kevin, thanks very much. Jay, congrats on the win and another triple double for you. How are you able to do this so consistently?
Hey, DA, man, you know the key for me is to bring the energy on both ends of the floor. You know, keep my feet moving, hands up, looking for opportunities. You know, many good things come from that starting point.
Well, it's been a whirlwind for you so far, and it's been very successful as well. Congratulations. Back to you guys.
David, thank you as always.
What a great guy. I love having him on the show.
Strong agree. We should have him on more often.
Yeah, I'm going to talk to James after the show. I'm sure he can make that happen.
Oh, yeah. Book it and cook it, Hank.
Congrats on being named All-Star Captain, Jay.
Oh, thanks, V-Money.
Want to give us a preview?
V-Money.
First? Come on, we've earned it.
That's highly classified, V Money. Come on, just a little.
Why do you call him V Money?
Do that, bro. I can tell you, I'll be looking at my team as a model. You know, when you want to be successful, you got to emulate the best, right? So that's my philosophy. Bring what we do in this locker room to the All-Star game, and you'll see the heat.
Imagine naming like one of the media members like a nickname, like V Money. What the fuck? Oh, what is this? Oh, input lineups and rotation decisions. Words are hard. Yes, finally. Thank you. The coaching staff will take your suggestions under consideration. Injuries, roster movements between games could cause lineups to get rebuilt. So check back often if you want to continue inputs. Yes, finally. I feel like I should have myself and Luca along with Porzingis up there every time. Boban's he's on fire, but at the same time he's tired. Should we put Powell in for him? I mean, he is a higher overall than him. I mean, but look at him. He's tired, though. I think we should. Let's give Boban, like, a rest. Now let's give Boban some resting minutes. Okay, so this is the lineup I'm going for. Super temporarily. So that Boban fucking gets that tired, I don't know what you call it, tire emoji. I don't know what the fuck you can call that. I mean, he's fired, but he's tired at the same time. So we'll give him rest. Just to say that, we'll just give him rest. I have 38 minutes. We're going to have Tim Hardaway Jr. at the shooting. I have Luka, 33 minutes. And Porzingis, 32 minutes. And we'll go from here. And now we have a game against Houston, dude. We have a game against Houston. By as I'm filming this, they did lose to the Lakers tonight, as I'm filming this. Fucking, you know what else even happened? Fucking Conor McGregor beat the Cowboy by 40 seconds. 40 fucking seconds. That's crazy. What a comeback. In his fucking first UFC match return. That is crazy.